who is going to win at the National TV Awards? Is it going to be X Factor, Britain's Got Talent, or Strictly? It's Heat Radio with me, Fear Tarrant, and I'm joined by the legend that is Mr. Dermot O'Leary.
Hello, Fear. How are you?
Very well. How are you?
Not bad. I'm a little bit freaked out being called a legend.
Well,
it's very nice.
You are. Oh, you are. Radio TV legend. I think you are. So you've got the National TV Awards.
Yep.
That's happening Wednesday night, tomorrow night.
Yep.
And you've been presenting it now for 6 years.
Is it six? I think it might be more.
Seventh.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah. No. Don't worry, because I don't know myself. So you could pretty much say anything. I think it's seven or eight. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a really fun show. It's one of those shows though that when you said it's tomorrow night, it's one of those shows that I go in like, it's like your homework. It's like an assignment that's got to be in. You sort of just go. You wake up in the morning, 6 months to go, and you're like, that's fine, 6 months away. And then it's suddenly 2 months away, and then suddenly it's a month away, and then it's a week away, and then you're like, oh my God, it's tomorrow night! I haven't done enough homework. But it's a fun show, it's a nice show.
How do you mentally prepare for it? Is it one of those things that you just kind of gear yourself up on the day, do a couple of star jumps and go out on the stage
detachment,
kind of thing?
Detachment, largely, because it's one of those shows where all your peers aren't listening to a word you're saying, because they're really respectful for the first part. And then it hits the first part and then everyone just wants to drink and smoke. So they just literally just disappear and then come back. And then, so you'll be, so the part of the top of the second part, we can normally do a kind of, hey, look who's here. And if any of those people are in their seats, it's a miracle, because by then they'll have just realised that someone they know is in a box. They go and raid a free bar or something. So yeah, it's one of the, I think because it's the end of January, so it's the end of dry Jan.
Yeah.
So it's a lot of people break the January, abstinence laws, because you know the NTAs, and then a lot of people, I think for the most part, it's kind of nice for me as well. There's a lot of people you haven't seen for a while,
yeah,
so it's a really social award show. It's nice,
and it's kind of a double celebration this year because it's falling on Burns Night, so
yeah.
I hear that there's kind of a Scottish theme going on, is
oh,
that
really?
Right?
No, we've just got a random bagpiper.
Oh, really?
Who's just going to come out, and I don't know if anyone's going to, you know, we just think we should do a nod, so we've got this lady who's just going to play bagpipe.
Have
it is
you
quite a random award. Oh, no, she's good.
Oh, right.
Yeah, don't worry.
It's not like a Honey G kind of style of bagpiping.
She's well versed in the pipe.
Okay,
yeah, she's like a chief piper or something.
We were saying it's coming towards the end of dry January, and actually there's been a bit of kind of knowledge on the amount of booze consumed at the National TV Awards. So I'm going to test you on your knowledge.
Good. I don't know this, so this is fantastic.
Oh, brilliant. Well, how many flutes of champagne are expected to be knocked back on the evening? Is it 42,000, 64,000 or 79,000 flutes?
Well, I've got some friends coming and I know... What is it? What's the last one?
79,000.
Let's go 79.
64,000.
It's not bad, is
it? Do you know what? I was thinking that.
That's
I was
an awful lot of champagne.
Definitely thinking you can easily yourself knock back what a good 30.
Wow.
I mean, if you have the haggis
yes,
and everything before. Okay, and how many glasses of wine on average are going to be drunk? Is it 72,000, 82,000, or 92,000?
72,000.
You are correct.
Yeah.
And how many of those will you be consuming?
72,000. Oh, the only rider I have, I just want glasses of wine everywhere in my dressing room.
Are you quite good? Are you quite focused? So before you go out on stage, you won't have a glass of wine?
I'd be useless if I drank before.
So you just save it all up for the end?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You say save it all up like I'm some alcoholic.
Okay,
yes.
No. Exactly.
As soon as it finishes.
Oh, dear. And right, if you were given the choice to present any show at all, what would it be?
Well, that's a good question, because you don't really sort of see it. Like TV's not like a shopping list. You don't just go, I want that. Can I have that one? I want that one.
Has there never been a show that you've turned around to your agent and gone, you know what? I think that person's useless. I can do a much better job.
I don't think I've ever said that.
No, maybe not so harshly.
Do you know, all I'd like to do, I love live telly. I love interviewing people. And so if I could do something that involved both of those two things, then I'd be very happy. But I don't think the show's out there at the moment.
Oh, okay. That's good to know. And if you had to spend a whole year with a star, it could be an actor, singer, TV presenter.
Let's strip it down. When you say whole year, what are we talking about?
24/7, they live in
every
your house.
Every single day.
I mean, they won't come into your bedroom whilst you're sleeping because that'd be a bit weird.
Yeah.
And
but other than that,
with you the whole time.
Do I go to their work or do they come to my work?
They can come with you. They fill around your life.
Oh, that's a really weird question.
I mean, I did do these late last night, so they get a little bit worse as well.
That's cool. Let's fanboy. Let's go. Hiddleston, I imagine would be good to roll with for a year, as with the batch.
Oh,
Cumberbatch.
Yeah.
One of those. Why not?
Okay, right. I'm going
to
do.
Also, they're learned men, so I imagine they'd quite like a little bit of downtime just to read.
Yes. Do you like reading?
I love it. That means that we could just both sit in silence for a little while rather than, what are we doing now?
Yeah. So Jedward wouldn't be there.
No. Maybe third.
So I'm going to do a quick fire round, just find out a little bit more about you, Dermot. It kind of sounds weird now. I'm going to say these out loud. So I apologise.
No way who do you want to spend a year with.
What shoe size are you?
Nine?
Okay.
Pretty much everyone else.
Best career moments?
I guess. Well, do you know what? One of them, weirdly, was dancing for 24 hours. That was good. That was a really odd career, because it was for charities, for Comic Relief in 2015. But it was probably the most emotional day of my life.
So you danced
apart
for 24
married.
Hours? Yeah. Make sure you don't miss that one out. So you danced for 24 hours?
Yeah. Waste £1 million.
Well done, you.
Yeah, it was great.
You deserve a knighthood for that. You should become Sir Dermot.
The last damn buster deserves a knighthood. I'll settle for a pat on the back.
Yeah. Okay, your best TV programme whilst growing up was?
MASH, Hill Street Blues, which I probably shouldn't have watched because it was quite dark. And there was a Cracker Jack I loved. I loved Grange Hill. And,
Grange Hill.
Yeah. The Machine Gunners was this kid's show that I really liked when I was a kid, Stick of the Dump. And it was a really random show. It was a bit like Indiana Jones, called Tales of the Golden Monkey. And it was about a guy in the 30s who had a flying boat. And we were allowed dinner in front of the television once a week. And that was always the show I watched.
Was it?
Yeah.
Well, I've not heard of it, but I'm going to have a look on YouTube and find out more about it.
Don't, because it's probably rubbish. It's one of those things that when you're a kid, you watch and go, this is the greatest show of all time.
And your best TV show now?
Well, we just finished watching The Crown. We're like massive drama fans, so I'd probably say that right now.
Okay, and your final question, who is going to win at the National TV Awards? Is it going to be X Factor, Britain's Got Talent, or Strictly?
Well, I would have to say X Factor.
Yeah.
I mean, I hope X Factor. BGT, I think, unfortunately for them, it falls when it's not on, because it's a massive show. But because it's not on air, I think people kind of vote what's foremost in their mind. But, you know, Strictly's had a great year. Keeps having great years.